Hi, y'all. It's Friday, Fit Friday. I pray you're having a wonderful day. My name is Latrice Bartley with Purposefully Living, and I just want to encourage you today to stay fit, to get fit, focused, intentional, and tenacious about Christ first and your goals second. Again, if you are maybe watching me or listening to me for the first time and you're like, what is purposefully living? Purposefully living, I just want to remind you, is reminding you that you were created for such a time as this. You were created on purpose and for purpose. And so why Fit Friday? Because I want to remind you to stay focused, to stay intentional, and to be tenacious. We're at the end of the week. Thank God it's Friday, right? But whatever your goals, whatever is going on in your day, whatever your week was like, I don't want you to just let go. Sometimes it's so easy to just say, I don't care. Thank God it's Friday. And we just let all the hard work that we put in Monday through Thursday go. And so it's just me encouraging you to stay focused, to keep at it, to not give up. Don't get weary. And so I was working out, which is why I look a hot mess. But y'all know I will come. Listen, at least you know I got fit. Spiritually and physically. But I just wanted to encourage you. I was working out and I was just meditating on a lot of stuff. And I just thought about two things that I want to share with you. Leaning. I thought about the song. Y'all remember the song? Leaning. Leaning on the everlasting arms. I thought about that song. And I thought about how things in our life can be good and bad. How something can represent good and bad. Anything good has the potential to be bad if it's not done in maybe the right proportion. I mean, even exercise, think about exercise, a good thing. But if you become so where it's your life and you're just working out. It can become bad because you're not allowing your body to rest and to reset. So, I just was thinking about how everything has that line, that fine line that you have to pay attention to. And so I thought about that because I thought about leaning, the act of leaning. And I thought about, when you think about leaning, it's not a posture you should take. You know what I mean? Like, if I'm just leaning, this isn't how I should sit. I'm going to get a cramp in my neck. I'm going to, it's not going to be well to just be leaning. I even thought about your car. If your car is leaning, or even when you need an alignment, it's normally leaning. You can let the wheel go and it's going one way. That's not good. So the act of leaning is just not a good posture. And so I thought about the scripture that reminds us to lean not to our own understanding, but in all thy ways to acknowledge Christ, to acknowledge God. But here's the thing, there is a leaning that's good. And that's where I thought about the song. And I even researched the words and I thought about, it says, what a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace in mind, leaning on the everlasting arms. Then it even goes on as another verse that says, safe and secure from alarms. When you think about things that would come to alarm us, but it says safe and secure from alarms, leaning on the everlasting arms. And I thought about that, right? Like, what does the everlasting arm mean? And it's representative of Jesus Christ. He's our anchor. And I thought about, my husband does this sometimes when I'm, you postured and you leaning on him good, and I'm leaning on him in the bed, and then he move his arm and you just go, and you like, I was leaning on you. And it's like, oh, well, I was uncomfortable. And it's like, but that was a good position. And you just move the pillow, move your arm, and sometimes that's what the enemy or life does. We in that position and it bulk us, because we leaning on the wrong thing. Or maybe we are leaning comfortably on something that we shouldn't. And the Lord has a way of, somebody you ever just been, they come knock your arm and you like, man, stop playing. I think sometimes the Lord like thumps some things to remind us that I ain't want you to get in that comfortable position. But I just thought about how important it is to lean on the everlasting arms, which I believe is representative of Christ. He's a solid foundation, an anchor for our soul, for our mind. What peace, what freedom we have from alarms, from sudden fears when we are leaning on the everlasting arms. I thought about, but to do that, you have to silence the background noise. You have to silence the distractions of life, of even good things. It's not just so much that TV is bad or movie watching is bad. Social media is bad. None of those things are bad. But when it's not put in its proper place and the proper timing, it has the potential to become a distraction. But when we're leaning on Christ, our rock, we can hear it. You know, I think about leaning, like I said, when I'm leaning on my husband, I like to get comfortable. He's normally warm. I just want to lay. It's a soft position. And I believe God just wants us to lean. He wants us to depend on him. And that's a good lean. But again, we have to silence the background noise so that when we lean on him, we can hear what he's saying to us today. So I know that might seem like, what does that have to do with Fit Friday? I want to encourage you to lean. I want to encourage you to check your posture, to check what your dependency is on. Because when you think about leaning, it's positioned against something. It's a posture. It's a position. And I even thought about how easy it is for us to assume a posture that sometimes we don't even realize it can really be detrimental to us. I even thought about how if you've been sitting a certain way, or even if you lie down a certain way, you wake up and you're like, oh, what happened? Because we had a posture, and then through the night you wake up with a cramp. But it's so important that we lean on Christ, the everlasting, our everlasting, he's a solid foundation in his everlasting arms. And so I just wanted to encourage you with that today. I was thinking about too, when I think about leaning, I think about depending, I think about, trusting. And I say this all the time, how our relationship with Christ is so different than naturally. I think about as a parent, I want, my kids, you know, to be their support. But Javier and I are raising them that one day they will stand on their 2 feet. I hope they're not leaning on me all their life. I don't want them positioned. Mommy and daddy are going to be here when we need them, but we want to raise them to be adults that can stand on their own 2 feet and that can make their imprint in the kingdom of God and in society, right? So that's the goal, to raise them to be independent adults that can have their place and do what God has called them to do. And so everything is like teaching them independence, teaching them how to clean up, teaching them how the little things to pick up after themselves, to pushing them to a task that maybe they didn't think they can do and pushing them to another task. But God is so the opposite. We soar. We begin to really develop when we depend on him. He wants us leaning. He wants us dependent. He don't want us to take anything for granted. He don't want us to take, oh, I got this. No, but he loves and relishes in us saying, Lord, what do you think? What I just received a new position. How should I lead the team? God, you know, we're getting ready to have a baby. I want to anoint my belly, and I'm giving this child to you before the child even comes out. Lord, I'm struggling with my weight. How do I get victory in this area? How should I eat? Like, there's nothing too small that we can't go to him about. He cares about everything, and he wants us to totally depend on him. And when we totally depend on him, when we totally lean in on him, that's where our growth, that's where we realize not only supernatural strength, but we begin to develop and grow. It's not in our independence. When we begin to move away, that's actually danger zone, but it's in drawing nigh. It's in leaning and depending. So that's all I wanted to leave you for Fit Friday. I want to encourage you to lean in on them this weekend, no matter what you're doing. If it's just working out, if it's chilling at the house, even while you're chilling, just lean in. Ask him, you know, what is it in this day that you would have for me to do? These are the goals that I have, God. Show me, direct me. I'm leaning in on you. I'm leaning on you because he's one that he won't leave you. He won't bolt your arm. Well, you know, if you're leaning on the wrong thing, he might thump you a little bit. But But he really is a support system. He's not going to have you lean in and just pull away and let you fall. But he said he'll never leave you nor forsake you. He'll be right there by you. So I want to encourage you today for this Fit Friday, lean in. Christ is your support system. I want to encourage you to move something, take care of your body, your mind, and your soul. Have a wonderful weekend. Fit Friday, stay focused, stay intentional, and definitely stay tenacious. Pursuing Christ first and your goals second. Bye.